We're going to join two pieces of aluminum with our Super Alloy 5 rod and flux and a propane torch. Now you notice the aluminum is sitting on a piece of wire. We do this to lift it up from the vise or from a table, as it will suck out all your heat and you'll be fighting it all day long. After broadly heating the aluminum, I'm going to grab some flux by heating the end of the rod. Now notice the technique. We're going to use the torch to melt the flux off onto the base metal. Now we're going to grab some more flux, come back in and heat the other side. Do not add the rod at this point. It's very important to let the flux do its job. The flux is a temperature guide. It's also opening the pores of the aluminum. Now if your rod balls up, that means your base metal is too cold. Just back off your rod, heat it up a little longer, then lay your rod in. So here we go. This is what you're looking for, that rod to flow right in there. And now we'll work on the other side. Perfect. At this point, stop heating your aluminum. Some people think it can't be this simple. Well, it is. When the rod flows out, you're done. Let your aluminum air cool naturally. Use warm water and a wire brush to easily remove the flux residue. Now customers ask us, what is the difference between you and the swap meet rods that don't use flux? Well, take a look at the backside. The Super Alloy 5 pulls all the way through to achieve the strongest joint. Our flux is the reason for this capillary action. As stated, the flux opens the pores of the aluminum, acts as a natural temperature guide, and is instrumental to achieving a perfect joint such as this one right here. Customers also want to know, how does this Super Alloy 5 polish? Well, this was sanded and polished over 3 months ago and is still looking beautiful today. This is the Super Alloy 5 from MuggyWeld.com.